Cyrillic, Cyrillic, Cyrillic. Now that I scared anyone who can't read this, hello there everyone, it's me. Back here with my never-ending rampage in Hearts of Iron 4. And today here we have a different kind of video, because few viewers told me to check out this mod called Another World. And as you can probably see from the Cyrillic, it means that this mod is only in Russian. I was trying to find English version of this mod, but I wasn't able to. That's why this video has the title of something along the lines, mod that you have never played before. Because I assume only people from Eastern Europe played it. And I'm making this video to pique interest in people, so this mod will have a higher chance getting an English translation so more people can enjoy it. Because I really like the setup and clearly a lot of work was put into this mod. But now, without any further ado, let me show you the select country screen. And yeah, can you guess which country is which? Don't you worry about anything, I will try to translate everything that I can with my 3 years of Russian. And if you want to read with me, here is alphabet. Now please, bear with me. I know that you have short attention spans, but please, I want to explain you the scenario from what I understand. So fucking finally, this is not a scenario of what if country X won World War Y. Here you can see that Western Roman Empire never fell. It's fragmented to many autonomous districts, but they are still under the authority of Rome. Then also Constantinople never fell, so we have here Byzantine Empire. The Germanic barbarians never unified Germany. Also there is Kingdom of Scandinavia. No British Empire, thank God. And also Russia never unified in this universe. Now here is where it gets interesting. Here in Asia you have Japan and this southern China. They possess Eastern British Empire and a French Empire, because they have colonies all around the world. Also Japan is here in America, China is in South America, and also here is Atlantic Federative Republic, and we can assume that this was Vinland. And also we have a new Russian Republic in America. What did you do to Ukraine? Also I think this was a Roman colony, so Byzantine Confederates. But now back to the video. I think I will play as Japonskaya Imperia, aka Japanese Empire. Privyet, hi there. You know what, I'm not going to translate this because I wouldn't be reading this even if it was in English, so I think the down option here will do fine. So yeah, we are the Japanese Empire, led by Yoshiro. I assume he is our emperor, because we are led by Conservative Party at 100%. We also have some modifiers, but I think most of them just take down our stability. It also seems like that the Japan rules the waves. We have a nice colonial empire composed of Japanese South Africa. Oh, just imagine a samurai apartheid. Then we have Siberia under our control, some bits of Australia and New Zealand, and lastly Morocco that stretches even in Brazil. Quite impressive empire, I have to say. Now I know that most of the people already gave up on this video, but I picked Japan because they have a nice little focus tree that shouldn't be that hard to navigate. So yeah, let's go for some bonuses. I don't even have to speak Russian to know what this exactly is. Now I don't know who decided that it would be a good idea if our soldiers just threw their rifles into the ocean, but oh fucking well. Ah, now we here have the first event. Read it if you can. Ah, now I understood this, the Baltic Federation is no more, it just fell apart. It is nice as Mink Explosion. Now this is about our emperor, and I will try to go with the first option here. I'm playing this game as if I was driving without any lights in complete darkness, while it was raining and I was going at least 180 km/h, and this is bad. Bye bye our stability and Warsaw support. Now the secret council of shoguns didn't pick the emperor option. I will try to see what the second guy can do. The last samurai of Fukushima. And we can see baby Yoda and samurai Mandalorian in the picture. Pretty epic if you ask me. Ah yes, our spy agency is ready. And again, I'm not going to choose the emperor option and see what will happen. Now I think we have a coup in our country and the building is in charge. Now hopefully this is not going to lead into a civil war. Now our empire shattered, but we are going to reclaim it. First starting with Siberia. So yeah, I don't think that this war will be hard. Oh no. Unfortunately, we have fallen into a civil war. We need to also quickly take care of that. Ah yes, the civil war with the past emperor. Now I think we can't afford any other wars just yet. But also our focus tree finally unlocked. Oh shit, we have some important decisions to make here. Let's go with something that doesn't have effects. Push to the south. It's not that hard. And yeah, we lost a chunk of Africa here. It's bad, we are slowly losing our colonial empire. Now I think this is about our Congo colony. Yeah, we need to go with something positive here. Oh fuck, I don't feel like we will be able to get here anytime soon. But now we have priorities. Japan was secured. Now on my way to secure Siberia. Just slowly going through this cold ass desert. Now we are not the only unstable country here in Asia. No, you just can't go out of your way to kill Chinese MILF leader, you monster. Finally, the Siberia was taken care of. Now we will focus on the south. Now in order to get to the south, we need to destroy their fleet. Oh shit, I don't really like this. Oh well, fuck. Oh well, maybe my fleet is not as good as I thought. But it's doing just fine, I think. For the most part. Now I don't think that this is something good. Would you look at that, even here in Manchuria there is fighting. I will slowly waste my enemies here on pointless naval invasions. And then I will just walk into empty country. Now would you look at that, even more chaos in this world. I really love it, infinite civil wars, let's go. Now here is something interesting for you. Mr. Popeman declared war on Roman Empire. It is looking very unstable here. Now slowly but surely we will go around their ships that are parked here and hopefully make it to undefended island. Almost. Now I was even able to quickly scramble another naval invasion. And now hopefully we can succeed here. Ah fuck, if I needed this shit too, Korea just declared war on me. Finally. Now hopefully this will be enough to take these idiots out. We only have 3 divisions on this invasion. Now these are the best tricks I was even able to encircle 2 divisions here. They are 1% towards capitulation. You don't even know how much pain this war is. Fucking kill me. Finally they are down. But at least we got our fleet back. So that's something nice. Now that we are finally unified, we have all agreed on that Japan has to destroy Korea with its entire army, of course. You know, you should have just guarded your country properly. Sorry Korea, but fuck you. I'm the only empire that is allowed to exist here in Asia. After encircling large portions of Korean army, I think this is the end. Korea is no more. It is the Japanese shogunate. Bongo bongo. I'm going to burn the entirety of Congo. You asked for it. You made me come here. My samurai warriors will decide your fate. Now the Japanese Empire has been partially restored under the shogunate. So yeah, today it will be a quicker video. You know, I can really appreciate the hard work that was put into this mod. And it shows. I got to say, I really like this mod. It has a lot of features. Also, check out the mod on the Steam page. I really like it. And thank you to all people who suggested this mod to me. I really hope that this mod will one day get English version, because it is just too good to stay just in Russian. So yeah, hopefully you enjoyed today's video. And if you did, leave a like and subscribe, because we are very close to 60,000 subscribers. And hey, if this was released on Monday. Happy Slav month! Yeah, actually this is the last video of this month. Anyway, as always, big thanks goes to my channel members and a special thanks goes to Lazuli and Quite Lazy for being the highest channel members.